Sweet. I made a cover plate from my, what do you call it? The heat riser hole in the Edelbrock manifold. I did it in hammered. Piece of stainless steel, and then one side you beat the hell out of it with a ball peen hammer. I got the carburetor up, and that's the hole right there. And it fits good, I just gotta make a gasket for it. It's friggin' cold today, man. Oh. Alright, I gotta get some gasket material and pop this thing on. It's right there. I can get it upside down. Where is it? There it is. Can't even see it. But it's in there and it's done. One less step. I spent Saturday over Dad's, pretty much, and we have the bushings in. I got tape around them so the pins don't fall out, but what I'm doing now is setting the depth, so how far they go, and now that they're compressed, of course, they don't fit width-wise. I got to take a little bit off this edge. I'm thinking I'll take it off the bottom, leave the top alone on both of these. I have them on the surface right now so I can align them, but when it comes down to it, that'll be there, and this one will be about right there. I get a little misalignment problem, but it's not too bad. I have to take some off of this one, but not a big deal. Alright, so I'm gonna be here for a while. I'll take pictures when I'm done. I'm not gonna keep taking a video every 5 minutes. Okay, happy Mother's Day. Okay, is my inner hinge plate 1/4 inch trimmed off, and I mean just setting it on there, you can tell. Now that bottom right corner in the picture there has to be rounded off, as does this bottom left corner, but we can do that after the fact, because of course when you turn the door it's going to want to pull into it. But looking good. Where's number two? What did I do with number two? There it is. I mean, it's not even touching it. It's a couple thousandths away from it. The bottom is about a 1/16. But you're not going to see it anyway. And let's check alignment here. I used my little bandsaw outside to do the cutting. What did I do with my square? It's over there. Come on, I got like three of them. Where's the third? All right, we'll go get this one. I trim the same. I got my big sheetrock square. I like using that one. Alright. And I have to do it with one hand. Especially when you drop one. Bugger. Alright, I give up. I'll try it myself without the camera in my other hand. Perfect. If I move, something's gonna fall. Alright, that means put this damn thing down. All that's left is to have the internal plates welded to the bushing at 3/8 spacing. Now I'm not even gonna try to hold them up there anymore. That one keeps falling. I just gotta clean up my other ones now. I need the other door basically put together. There's the skin and there's the frame. All right, a couple more to do and we can get them welded. Let's put that other door together. Door number two is together. I have a quarter of an inch trimmed off of both of the hinge plates that go on the door. And I have an arrow pointing up. I gotta take a little bit off the top edge so the weight of the door doesn't make it scrape on the hinge, because these plates are actually the ones that go on the door and the ones that go on the firewall are the same thickness. I should have made this one a couple thousandths thinner at the top, but I'm gonna grind that top edge, grind this top edge, check them all out, set them in place, do a little trimming on the other half of the hinge, and we should be good to go. Now I wire tied them together so I can't screw them up when I get them welded. A friend of mine's gonna weld them up with a TIG, because MIG would be nice, but TIG would be so much cleaner. All right. This side is just about done. I gotta trim the tab off that end, but they do line up top to bottom. Now they have a, I'll show you, I marked the line. The line is level. They have about a 2 degree tilt down because I wanted to bring this hinge just a little closer to the panel versus sticking it out an inch and a half like the factory one did. What's that mean? Well, I'll open my door and it'll kind of fall open a little bit, but nothing crazy. Over here, I'm just starting. What I'll do is I'll drill a quarter inch hole and get my center line, and then I'll drill like a half inch hole, because the back is going to be plates instead of nuts and bolts. I'm actually going to use these. The plates I mated, that I made for the original hinges, are going to go in the back. Mated? What the hell's mated? That's going to be my plate once I clean it up. Now we'll go behind. Now the half inch hole is so I'll have tilt left, right, up, down, back, forth. It can be adjustable only on the firewall, because at the door you can't adjust it. I can shim it here, I can tilt it, just about everything. Now a question was, the firewall is straight and the hinges are straight, so that leaves a little bit of a gap. These might have to be bent that way just a little bit, right at that seam. But it's going pretty good, not too shabby. Gotta move that up a little before I drill them holes. Now the factory hinges were set the same way. They left a gap about an eighth of an inch top and bottom in the sheet metal so they could adjust it. If you thought about what was here, this was a piece of wood. These were flathead screws and it was really inaccurate. There wasn't much to go by. My factory hinges were junk. I should have kept them, but they were junk. They're rebuildable, but nothing you could reuse. I do have that second hole. There's a hole here and there's a hole behind this for the dash bracket. I might just plug weld it back there, plug weld this one, because I want to put something over this. There's an eighth inch lip here on the sheet metal. This is all 3/16 plate, and the intention was to put something over this inside the lip, whether it be aluminum or who knows what, but we'll think of something when we get there. But right now I have to get this plate flush with the outside of the body, top and bottom, and it looks pretty good. So I'm going to move it up just a hair and then drill those holes. Now I clamped the tube over here. I had a piece of 1 inch. You can see the tilt. It's nothing great. But I clamped the tube top and bottom to the plates themselves to keep it straight, of course. Because if these pins don't line up, we're going to have a hell of a click. That door's going to flex when we open it. And you don't want that. But that's the tilt right there. It's about 2 degrees. It's not too bad. I'm going to have to take a little bit off of this one to square that up with the edge. This one I'm just going to mark it on the back and cut it eventually, but not right now. I want to get the other one cracking, so I'm going to pull these vice grips off, move the tube over to that side, and finish drilling some holes. Looking good. All lined up. Little about 2 degree tilt. Not a big deal. I got the second part of the hinges just sitting in there. Oh, we waste nothing here. This is the original hinge. The Mickey Mouse kind of like it worked when we needed it. I cut the other piece in half, and I now have nut plates for the backside. Problem is, I only ever made 3 of these hinges, so I gotta make another nut plate for the bottom on that side. This one has one, and the top has one over there. But I got nothing down here, so I'm gonna take this one out and duplicate it on the bandsaw. I can do it one hand for you. So, there it goes. That's all it is. Piece of 3/16 with 1/4-20 threads in it in the right spots. Oh, wait a minute. There's one right there. Of course, that's what I was going to do. Alright, let's cut this one up on the bandsaw. Keep saying the bandsaw. It's my little bandsaw. I pulled this thing out of the junkyard. Me and Dad rebuilt it, and the thing works beautiful. Actually, one of the old hinges is right there, and the other two are right there. So I'm going to cut this one and thread it up and put it on the other side. The, I'd call them thread plates, nut plates, whatever you want to call them. Both sides are done. I used the ones, like I said, that I had before. You know what? I need this. And I need this, because I have to make 4 more for the doors. I work a lot better than putting nuts on it, so this one's all done. And these are straight. Where's my door? I have to make the nut plates to go on the back side of these. Awesome. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4 more nut plates to make. And I'll just make them from this. Here we go again. Thank you. didn't know you had any feelings. Well, all the hard work for the hinges is done. I have drilled and capped 3, 6, 9, 12, 15 holes, 9 of which were already drilled and capped because we reused those plates. Oh, my arm is killing me. Tapping holes. I ran out of the Allen heads because I got these in there for now. We'll get some more of these. Maybe flatheads like I originally had, who knows. But there's one plate sticking out. The threaded back plate is behind it. And same thing on all four. This one has it and this one has it too. But it's been a long day of drilling, tapping, aligning, measuring, cutting, grinding, smoothing, you name it. I didn't cut that flap off yet because I'm not going to do that till the doors are on, and that one either. So now they got to come off again. The whole, all, every one of them got to come off, got to be welded. Then we can put them back on, cut the little flaps off. I might do that before I take them off the next time I'll mark it. But I'm going in, guys. Have a good night.